grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My beloved brothers and sisters, we are celebrating the second Sunday of Lent. And so, to celebrate with joy the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God, my brothers and sisters,
Genesis. The Lord said to Abraham, leave your country, your family, and your father's house, for the land I will show you. I will make you a great nation. I will bless you and make your name so famous that it will be used as a blessing. I will bless those who bless you. I will curse those who dislike you. All the tribes of the earth shall bless themselves by you. So Abraham went as the Lord told him. This is the word of the Lord.
Gente.
interpreting is a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. God calls and invites himself. With me, bear the hardships for the sake of the good news, relying on the power of God who has saved us and called us to the body, to the Lord. Not because of anything we ourselves have done, but for his own purpose and by his own grace. This grace had already been granted to us in Christ Jesus before the beginning of time, but it has only been revealed by the appearance
presence, he was transfigured. His clothes became dazzlingly white, whiter than any earthly witcher could make them. Elijah appeared to them with Moses, and they were talking with Jesus. Then Peter spoke to Jesus. "Rabbi," he said, "it is wonderful for us to be here. So let us make three tents, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." He did not know what to say. They were so frightened. And a cloud came, covering them in shadow. And there came a voice from the cloud, "This is my son, the beloved. Listen to him." When they looked round, they saw no one with them anymore but only Jesus. As they came down the mountain, he warned them to tell no one that they had seen until after the Son of Man had risen from the dead. They observed the warning faithfully, true among themselves. They discussed what rising from the dead would mean. This is the Gospel of the Lord. The gospel that we heard today, on this second Sunday of Lent, speaks to us about two high mountains. The first one, it's called by the tradition, as we heard in the gospel, as the Mount Tabor. The other one, it is the Sinai, where Moses received the tables, the tablets. And what he said to us in the gospel, it is that Jesus gave us a new and totally different law. That law is not written in stone, but instead of that, it is written in our hearts. And that law, it's the law of love. That is the most important law that we have. Why Jesus appeared in the middle of Moses and Elijah? Because Moses and Elijah spoke by the first one, by the law, and the second one, by the prophets, about Jesus. They spoke about him. And I think that the most important here is to understand what we heard from that cloud. "This is my son, the beloved, listen to him." If you remember the chapter 6 from the book of Deuteronomy, we'll see there that starts, "Hear Israel." I think that you remember the Shema in Hebrew. And we are invited also to listen. Not only with the ears of our flesh, but above that, with the ears of our hearts. And to hear Jesus Christ, it is to put in practice what he commanded us to do. And that is, as I told you, to love. And so, I think that is the most important message from the Gospel today. To love. We saw also the Mount Tabor, and there is another mount in the life of Jesus, the Golgotha. We can learn also, my brothers and sisters, that we cannot have what Jesus told us about the rising from the dead, the resurrection, without the Golgotha. All of us who are here have to pass by the way of the dead to have the resurrection. All of us one day will close our eyes to this world as Jesus gave us the example, and also with him to resurrect for a new life, a life to come. And so, my beloved brothers and sisters, let us put in practice what Jesus commands us to do. Not only to love, but to listen to Him. And we listen to Jesus not only in the readings, in the texts, no. We listen to Jesus when we see somebody that is really poor, that is really needy, from not only love, but from food, from everything that every human being needs. It is Jesus that is speaking by that person. Also, we listen to Jesus when we go away from a place to be with Him, to pray. Not only to make a prayer, sorry for the microphone, not only to make a prayer that is like an Hail Mary or our Father, no, more than that, to speak with God as we speak with our friends, with our family. We can hear the voice of God in our hearts every single day. May so the Virgin Mary, Mother of the Divine Word, and also Mother of the Lord, Giver of Life, protect our homes, families, and friends. Let us proclaim our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born from the Father of all ages, born from God, light of light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through Him all things were made, for our strength, for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit, received the name of the Virgin Mary, He came back. For our sake, He was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, according to the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory. Church the living and the dead, and is seen in the path of heaven. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead. And the life of the world will come. Amen. You may see it, my friends.
Et leva amor.
Pray, grant that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacrifice, O Lord, we pray, cleanse us of our faults and sanctify your faithful in body and mind for the celebration of the Paschal festivities. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord Holy Father, Almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For after he had told the disciples of his coming death, on the holy mountain he manifested to them his glory, to show even by the testimony of the law and the prophets that the passion leads to the glory of the resurrection. And so with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty, without end, we acclaim singing.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis cum celi et terra, gloria tua. Hosanna in excelsis,
of my blood, the blood the Savior's command, and formed by the divine teaching, we are there to say,
Our Father, the Lord be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Ayus Dei, Titolis peccatus.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Have a great week.